of time, man has quested for odd things. From the natural to the supernatural. From the normal to the abnormal. From the average citizen to the George Pirsko. In search of George Pirsko. Who is he? What is he? And where is he? Tonight, we'll attempt to answer these burning questions. We also have rare footage of a startling interview with Rachel Denning, his future wife. Inside one of George Pirsko's favorite haunts and ask people who George Pirsko really is.
Here for the House of Commons.
Alfred E. Newman is a pretty laid-back kind of guy. As a matter of fact, his motto is, what, they worry? He's short, kind of medium build. He's got a big smile and a gap right here between his teeth. Something like this. And,
I get a description of George Pirsko.
He's big, has a fire coming out of his mouth, has these things on his back that stick out. And he's like a dinosaur.
Thing of Mickey Mouse is he is a fake mouse. Well, not really a fake mouse. A big, giant mouse. A giant mouse.
Okay. Chad's got to go out with me. Not real tall. He's married. It's real sad. Freckles, like mine. Got kind of sandy hair. It's real cute.
Big, hairy.
Huge.
Good looking, blonde, blue-eyed, built a star all the way.
With Rachel Denning, George Pirsko's personal fiance. Hello, Rachel. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I would like to ask you a question. How long have you known George?
Oh, about 15 years.
15 years? Wow. That must have meant he was about, 10?
Yeah.
And how old were you?
I was about 5.
5. And where did you get those ears?
Oh, they just kind of grew here.
I see. And the rest of it?
My little tail just kind of grows here. It's like lots of little carrots.
Oh. Hey, let's get a full shot of this. Okay, full shot.
Tell us a little bit about George.
Oh, he's a wonderful man. And he's just gentle. And I don't know if you know this, but he's into small animals. That's why really likes his carrots. And he seems just to be such a wonderful guy.
What was it like the night you first met?
The night we first met? Well, gee, since I was only 5 years old, I think we met during, was it Jack's or was it baseball game? It must have been a game of Jack's.
Oh, I see. Come in a little bit closer. Closer, close up. Close up on her. Okay, come in closer so you can hear her, too. Okay, what about the first kiss? Tell me about it.
He kissed me on the cheek.
Oh, he did? Well, maybe we can go for a little bit better than that. Let's go see George right now. Go ahead. Fade it out.
Pretty good, Randy.
How are you doing?
All right.
I'll tell you what. Come over here. Come on. My goodness, what a stubborn one. Come on. You're just like a mule. Come on. Come on. And he's going to run away from me. Okay.
Come on, George.
Have a seat. There you go.
Hey, but you sit on his neck.
My goodness gracious, talk about stubborn. How you doing?
Is this a blackmail thing?
No, it's not a blackmail thing. I'll tell you what, I was saying there were 3 reasons. Number one, I understand you're getting married. Yeah, I'm correct, but I'm going to sing you a little song. And number two, I'm going to tell you he did this terrible thing to you. And number three, oh, you know. And I'm going to embarrass the hell out of you in front of everybody here. Try. Oh, you look a little bit. Oh, now he's going to be calm and cool. Get back here. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll sing you a little song, okay? Is that all right? You can see, okay? Congratulations, I'm all so happy. Gonna shout hooray for you. Salutations, you're getting married now, mate. All your dreams come true. Well, let's go on your show today. You're a Jonathan. Salutations, I'll be specific. Couldn't have it to a nicer guy than you. Well, you know that we'll always stand tall behind you. And we'd like to remind you that you're the top. Congratulations, I'm all so happy. Gonna shout hooray for you. Salutations, you're getting married. Now may all your dreams, may all your dreams come true. You are the shoot you. Congratulations, baby. That wasn't so bad, was it? No? Look at you, you're not enjoying yourself at all, are you? They said you were real shy. Kind of afraid of girls, huh? But they told me you're really into small animals, so they have you dressed like a little puppy, okay? And I tell you what, I like to give all my bachelors a little piece of my tail, so that's for you, okay? Now, I have this garter here, and you get to keep it. See, there's a little red whistle here, okay? And you get to blow it when you want to be wrecked. You want to try that? Come on.
Come on.
Okay, I'll shut it off.
She's all chicken and shit.
There you go, that's my whole thing. There are 3 rules of golf. Number one, you can't smoke off your back hurt, and I don't need me, okay? Number two, you can't get your teeth or any part of your face to lose my garden. And don't get kinky on me, I've heard all about you, okay? And number three, my garden only goes one way, and that's down, unless I'm standing on my hands, and I don't do that with too many fellows, okay?
George, tell us all about it.
not. I had nothing to do with it. Another exciting installment of In Search of the Odd and Unusual. This is Randy Hughes saying good night and good evening.
It's still, that's okay, just let it go. Just let the fade.